Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel Strictly Logical. As exams are approaching and you feel not prepared, you better start preparing from today itself. Exams and that means ek saath pura syllabus yaad hona chahiye, means pura syllabus apne dimag mein condensed hona chahiye. Also, if you are in higher classes, the course or study material seems to be endless. Teachers also suggest a lot of reference books for succeeding during the exams. But is it possible to learn and revise all the study material you have at the last moment of examination? No, impossible. But ये तभी possible है जब आपके पास proper notes हो. So let's see why is it important to make notes. अब आप बोलोगे कि हम directly book से ही क्यों ना पढ़ लें? Textbook में ही highlight कर लेते हैं या फिर underline कर लेते हैं. Actually, there is no limit to how much one can learn. We have so many sources of information. मैंने आपको मेरे लास्ट वीडियो में भी बताया था कि जो भी हम पढ़ते हैं, जो भी हम इंफॉर्मेशन गेन करते हैं, उसका सिर्फ 20% हमारे माइंड में रिटेंशन होता है. तो जो 80% इंफॉर्मेशन हम लूज कर रहे हैं, उसको हम समराइज्ड वे में अपनी लैंग्वेज में लिख के प्रिजर्व कर सकते हैं इन द फॉर्म ऑफ नोट्स. नोट्स हेल्प यू टू कीप अ रिकॉर्ड. यू आर फिजिकली इन मैथ्स क्लास लास्ट ट्यूजडे, but that doesn't mean you remember what happened in that lecture and what might appear on a quiz. So notes are a record of what you have learned before, after and during the class. तो अब जब हमने जान लिया है कि notes बनाना क्यों important है, तो चलिए अब हम देखते हैं notes बनाए कैसे and most importantly उसमें लिखना क्या है और कैसे लिखना है. So let me take you to the ride of note making to ace your next exam. To make better notes, you need to understand the 5 R's of note taking. So the first R is record. This begins during the lecture. Tell me, during the lecture, do you write down every single word your teacher says in the class? Or do you only take notes when your teacher writes something on the board? Or do you start writing anything when the teacher tells you to do so? Also, does your history teacher mention the date of a key civil war battle? Does your English teacher give examples of Shakespeare's use of dramatic irony? Does your math teacher go over a particular formula? Obviously, teachers always tell little details which are not there in textbook or in handouts. So it's very important to note down all the little but important information. जब टीचर एक्सप्लेन कर रहे होते हैं, तब आपको उनको ध्यान से सुनना होता है. बीच बीच में टेक्स्ट बुक या स्लाइड्स या अदर हैंडआउट से भी पढ़ते हो, कॉन्सेप्ट समझना होता है. एंड यू हैव टू राइट नोट्स एट द सेम टाइम, विच इज नॉट जस्ट डिफिकल्ट, इट्स प्लेन इम्पॉसिबल. Because if you focus too much on getting your notes right, you might miss listening to what the teacher is saying. So, cut down the number of notes you take in lectures and do more listening. To write precise points, be an active listener and identify keywords. For instance, notice when words or phrases are being repeated. Underline or circle in your notes any words that seem to be significant. Some teachers may mention lots of dates and facts in class, but only write the key ones on the board. Other teachers might not write anything down, but may repeat a certain date or piece of information. That's a clue that it's probably important. आपको उन्हीं clues को catch करना है. Those are keywords. Keywords के पास ही आपको exam में अच्छे marks से pass कराने की key है. So don't forget to identify and write keywords. Now the next R is for reduce. रिड्यूस मीन्स कम करना. मीन्स हमने जो भी 30-45 मिनट्स के लेक्चर में पढ़ा है या फिर टेक्स्ट बुक के 10-15 पेजेस के चैप्टर में पढ़ा है, वो सब समराइज करना है, रिड्यूस करना है. सो द रिडक्शन प्रोसेस स्टार्ट्स एट द एंड ऑफ द लेक्चर और व्हेन यू हैव कंप्लीटेड द होल चैप्टर. सो आफ्टर द लेक्चर पुट सम टाइम असाइड सून टू सिट समवेयर क्वाइट एंड कंसिडर वॉट यू हैव जस्ट लर्नड. समराइज एंड राइट वॉट यू थिंक वर द मेन पॉइंट्स इन फ्यू सेंटेंसेज. You can add anything you need or want to find out more about and any questions if raised in your mind. Also follow up on anything that you think it's important. Find out the answers yourself. You can also discuss it with your friends. Make a list of questions to raise if you have any doubts. Then file your notes carefully so you can find them whenever you need them for assignments or revision. Now next, before explaining to third R, let me tell you some strategies to make your handwritten notes user-friendly. First point is, make your notes brief and be selective. For that, read the original text multiple times, ensuring you don't miss any critical point. Ensure the summary is much shorter than the original source. Second, use your own words, your thoughts and ideas to summarize. Try to make your notes in A4 sheets and you can organize them in spiral files. Keep them well spaced so you can see individual points and add more details if necessary. कभी कभी किसी टॉपिक के बारे में हमें इन्फॉर्मेशन बहुत सारी जगहों से मिलती है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंटरनेट से या यूं ही फ्रेंड्स के साथ बातों बातों में पता चल जाती हैं, तो कभी कभी किसी कॉन्सेप्ट को हम प्रैक्टिकल या डेली लाइफ एग्जाम्पल से समझ लेते हैं. यू कैन ऐड ऑल दीज एक्स्ट्रा इन्फॉर्मेशन टू योर मेन नोट्स इफ़ यू कैन ऐड मोर पेजेस. नोटबुक में पेजेस स्टिक होते हैं, लिमिटेड होते हैं, बट इन स्पाइरल फाइल्स वी कैन ऐड और रिमूव एनी नंबर ऑफ पेजेस अकॉर्डिंग टू आवर रिक्वायरमेंट. Spiral files have advantage that you can add or remove sheets in between if you like. It's quite convenient. Next point is, try to use tables, mind maps, concept maps or examples and diagrams to understand the concept in a better manner. Make your notes memorable using different colors of pens, patterns. You can highlight them or underline them. And the last main point is, read through all your notes to make sure that they are clear. Because at the end, you should be able to understand them while revising. Now, the third R stands for recite. Using only keywords, recite the whole information out loud. It will help you to retain information. Or you can also tell someone all about what you have learned. मैंने ये आपको अपने पिछले वीडियो में भी बताया था कि आपने जो भी कॉन्सेप्ट समझा है, जो भी इन्फॉर्मेशन गेन करिए, यदि आपको उसको और अच्छे से समझना है या उसको रिवाइज करना है, It's better to explain the whole thing to someone else. You can teach your friends or you can just read it loud to your parents, your siblings. That's how you can revise it easily. Now the next R tells us to reflect. Means this is the stage of self-questioning. Self-questioning can improve long-term retention of knowledge and skills as well as your ability to apply and transfer the knowledge and skills you have learned. At this stage, just ask yourself few questions. For example, what is the significance of these facts? How can I apply them? Or what principle are they based on? How do they fit in the context that I already know? Or what's beyond them? अब जब हमारा syllabus हमने summarized कर लिया है, notes भी बन गए हैं, self questioning भी कर ली है, now what's next? Collecting even excellent notes for several weeks and expecting to learn them right before the exam is a recipe for failure. Learning is like exercising for fitness, which happens over time, not all at once. So your next move must be review. And that is the fifth R of note making. Spend some time reviewing your previous notes. If you do, you will retain a great deal for present use as well as you can identify the improvements or the best practices which are required for your future notes. So friends, these 5 R's of note making are very important to understand before moving on to the techniques of note making. In my next video, I will show you how can we make concept map, mind maps. There are different techniques to make the notes. For those techniques, we need these small details. So do start following all these steps which I have mentioned in this video. And I will see you all in my next video with all the interesting techniques that we can use to make our notes effective. Thank you for watching, and if you are new to my channel and haven't subscribed yet, then what are you waiting for? Do subscribe and get interesting videos every week. Happy learning!